see I'm filming. Say hi.
Well, folks, it looks like our animal care specialists got to ask the dolphins to join them. So they're going to be getting the dolphins out front, and they're going to come out and do a grand hello for you. Currently, the four ladies, well, and some gents that you'll be meeting momentarily are located in one of their behind-the-scenes enclosures.
Hello!
Many rooms for them to explore. So it looks like they're getting our ladies and young gent ready to start this off. So hopefully they'll start making their way forward soon and you folks will get to meet all of our dolphins. So looks like they're getting them ready. So I'm going to look up at Joanna and ask her to restart that music. All right.
Thank you.
spirit for our very playful dolphins and their animal care specialists. Now, just a few moments ago, you heard me mention that there are many different roles our animal care specialists play here at Seven Seas. And one of their most important roles is dolphin teacher. Because dolphins do have the ability to learn things from one another through a process called mimicry. But a
Jesse,
lot of the
think?
Behaviors that you'll see happen here at Seven Seas have been perfected by our animal care specialists. So we're going to show you one of the techniques that Allison is learning right now. Now, traditionally, you folks are used to seeing our dolphins leap up into the air and jump back into the water nose first. Well, we're going to be asking Allison to try it backward. It's called a back bow, and it'll look very similar to a backflip. So let's see how her education is going. Great job! Let's hear it for her! Alright, so you heard me mention that our animal care specialists do a lot of different things, but that's because we're also a part of the world's longest study of a wild dolphin population. It takes place in Sarasota Bay, Florida, and for the last 45 years, it's been managed by us, the Chicago Zoological Society. And one of the very first things our scientists and researchers recognized were the different ways dolphins can communicate amongst one another. And throughout this presentation, you'll see a lot of communication between me, the animal care specialists, and our dolphins. But when the dolphins communicate amongst one another, they'll use a series of vocalizations that you folks will get a good listen to. We ask you to keep in mind that dolphins don't have any vocal cords. So all the sounds you hear them make come from the blowhole located at the top of their head. We'll give it a listen.